Today we're going to be talking about how to identify fractions. Here's our standard for the current unit that we're starting. Our learning goal is that we hope to recognize fractions as representing a part-to-whole relationship. Let's try one together. We want to name this fraction. The first thing we have to do is see how many equal parts our one whole is broken into. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. That becomes our denominator, or the number on the bottom. We now have to go back and see how many parts are shaded in. We have 1, 2. This becomes our numerator, or the number on top. Therefore, this fraction is written as 2/4. Let's try another one. We're going to do it the same way. First, we need to count how many equal parts our one whole is broken into. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Again, that number becomes our denominator, the one on the bottom. We now have to go back and count how many are shaded in. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That, again, is our numerator, making this fraction equal to 6/9. We're going to see what these benchmark fractions equal to one another. A benchmark fraction is just a common fraction that you can use to compare. We're going to solve it the same way we did the other ones. We know that this top one is broken into 1, 2 parts. And how many are shaded in? 1, 2. So we have 2 out of 2. We're going to do the same one with the same thing with the one on the bottom. How many parts is it broken into? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then how many are shaded in? 1, 2, 3, 4. Both of these are equal to one whole because all of their parts are shaded in. But with a benchmark fraction, we can notice that 2/2 is equal to 4/4. The next three problems you're going to try on your own. You're going to label this fraction, as well as this one. And for this last problem, you're going to write what each of these benchmark fractions are. And I hope that you're able to see that they are equal to one another. Thanks, and I'll see you tomorrow.